Shalom and welcome to 2 Minutes of Torah. This year is entitled Daf Yomi Moed Katan Chaf Aleph Amud Aleph, and it discusses the halachot of an avel learning Torah. Previously on Tetvav Amud Aleph, we discussed an avel learning Torah, whether he has the heter to learn the sad areas that he's allowed to learn on Tisha B'Av. We discussed it in the Rambam versus Rabbeinu Tam. Rabbeinu Tam had a shita at first. He held like the Rambam, and then he changed his mind. An avel can learn the sad areas like he can on Tisha B'Av, and the Shulchan Aruch passes this way. On Chaf Amud Aleph, it discusses the different halachas of learning Torah, and the Shulchan Aruch passes that he cannot get an aliyah. An avel can't get an aliyah, not on the weekday, not on Shabbat. Because what is Kriyat HaTorah? It's Tamud Torah B'Rabim. So therefore, an avel should not get an aliyah, not during the week and not on Shabbat. There are several exceptions. One, if the Gabbai made a mistake and called the avel up on Shabbat. So at that point, if the avel does not go, it's obvious that he's not going because of what's known as avelut b'farhesi. It's a public display of avelut. Public display of avelut is asur on Shabbat, and therefore he must go and get the aliyah. Another example is Rabbeinu Tam. He always received shlishi. That was the kavod given to him. The Gabbai did not call Rabbeinu Tam up on Shabbat when he was in Avel, and Rabbeinu Tam went anyway. He took the initiative and took the aliyah, because he said if he doesn't get the aliyah, that would be a sign of Avelut b'farhesia, and therefore he went up to receive the aliyah without even being called. The third case in the Shulchan Aruch is, let's say he is a Kohen. The Avel is a Kohen. There is no other Kohen. And therefore, if the Gabbai calls up Yisroel b'makom Kohen, well, it's obvious why isn't this avel getting aliyah? Because of avelus b'farhesia. It's a demonstration of avelus publicly. And therefore, he must get the aliyah. Fourth case is in Pitchei Tshuva. Brings down, let's say a person has a yurid site, or his wife just gave birth, or any situation where he normally would receive an aliyah on that Shabbat. But because he's an avel, they choose not to give him the aliyah. Well, it's obvious he's not getting the aliyah. Why? Because of avilut. That's an example of avilut for Hesia. He can and he should receive the aliyah. In all these cases, it's examples of avilut for Hesia. What you see from here is avilut for Hesia does not mean he necessarily has to do an act of avilut for Hesia, but simply any indication that he is an avel and is public on Shabbat, that is an example of avilut for Hesia. Yes, Hashem, we should just have slachot.